Hello, I'm Graham and welcome to today's video in which I have another product review for you, and it's the Neewer radio trigger system. Now, you'd use radio triggers where you have problems with optical triggering, say between your camera and your remote flash using optical triggering, in situations where you've got high ambient light levels or you haven't got perfect line of sight between the flash transmitter of your camera and the receiver window of the slave flash. So in that situation, the use of radio triggers can give you better reliability. Optical flash trigger systems normally work up to about 50 meters outdoors. With the radio triggering system, you can work to about 100 meters, so you've got far more versatility with a radio triggering system. Obviously, they are just a dumb system. They don't transmit any ETTL or ITTL information from the camera at this level of complexity. There are radio triggers that will work with ETTL or ITTL mode, but they are more expensive. These are really just extensions of the center pin of the hot shoe from the camera to the remote flash to fire the system. The system comes as a pair of transmitter and receiver, but you can add additional receivers if you want to add more flash units to the setup. The transmitter and receiver can be set to either one of 16 channels by use of dip switches on the transmitter and the receiver units. So if you are working in an environment with other people using radio triggers, you can select a channel that's not being occupied by other people. If I remove the transmitter from the hot shoe of the camera, have a look at it in more detail. On the base of it, we have the locking collar, so you can attach this to your hot shoe and it won't slip out. Just a single electrode that enables the system to operate. On the side of the transmitter is an input socket, so you can connect cameras with a PC connection. That's the old Pronto Compo system. So if your camera doesn't have a hot shoe and it has a PC sync cable, then you can use this connecting cable between the PC socket of the camera and the input of the remote trigger. On the side of the unit was a slide switch which enables the operation as either a flash transmitter, or we can use the system in combination with the receiver as a remote shutter trigger. So as well as being able to flash trigger, we can actually use this, if we're not using it as a flash triggering system, as a remote camera trigger device. So being a dual use device gives you more flexibility in your camera bag. The units are powered by two AAA batteries which fit into the battery compartment on the underside of each unit. With the transmitter mounted onto the camera hot shoe, the voltage on the transmitter pin is sensed by the camera, and the camera then knows that it's got an external speedlite attached or some device which is providing power to it. It then enables the camera to set the synchronization speed, and in the camera setup manual under the flash control, you'll set the speed that you want the external flash or the trigger to operate at, either in the automatic mode, which will then go from the manual exposure you've set on the camera up to the maximum synchronization speed the camera supports, and in this case, a 250th of a second. These Speedlite transmitter receivers will work up to a 320th of a second if you've got different cameras with different synchronization speeds, but they won't support the high-speed sync modes that you can use up to a 2,000th or 4,000th of a second. These basic units don't support that. You have to look for additional radio triggers that will work at high-speed sync speeds. So with the transmitter attached to the camera, and now if I look at the receiver part, we have a similar sized physical dimension receiver as the transmitter, and again we have the hot shoe mount, this time again with a 1/4-20 threaded hole on the bottom so you can mount it on a light stand, and on the top surface we have the hot shoe with just a single electrode which is the triggering pin for your flash unit locked in place, and again a friction lock device so that the flash won't fall off your receiver. Again, we have the four dip switches which allow us to set to the same frequency that the transmitter's on. A LED again, which will remind us that we're either in a flash trigger mode and that will flash green, or a remote camera trigger which will flash red. Both devices are powered by AA batteries which fit in a battery compartment on the bottom of the unit. On the side of the unit, we have the slide switch between the flash operation and the remote camera trigger. On the other side of the receiver are two sockets. One is marked camera and the other is marked flash. If your flash doesn't support a hot shoe mount, and some of the old flash units didn't, then you can use this adapter cable again between the 2.5mm plug and the PC socket. And that would go into the flash output port, and then this would plug into the PC socket on your flash unit. So using these wireless triggers actually creates a new lease of life for some of the old flash guns, which had too high a trigger voltage and would probably destroy modern digital cameras. But because the electronics in these triggers are normally quite large, we can have devices in there which will tolerate the high voltage from some of the old flash guns. And I quite often use my triggering systems with a flash gun that has a 320 volt trigger, and it gives me the opportunity of using some very high power guns on my digital cameras. The other socket is marked camera, and we'll talk about that when we talk about the remote shutter release operation. So with the receiver turned on, and I'll mount this into a stand so we can see the operation. The receiver is set to the flash mode. I'll turn on the flash unit, and it would normally be in the manual mode for using external flash. With the transmitter turned on and the receiver turned on and the flash turned on, when I depress the shutter button on the camera, first of all, halfway down the camera will focus and we'll get the focus acquisition beep. And then when I fully depress the shutter button, the camera will transmit the trigger pulse into the transmitter. It will then transmit wirelessly by radio frequency over to the receiver, and that will in turn transmit the pulse into the flash unit. So I'll press the shutter button halfway down, there's the focus acquisition, and I'll fully depress the button, and the flash fires synchronously. Do that again just in case you couldn't see the flash pulse, as sometimes the flash pulses don't show up in video. Focus acquisition, and fired. If you had multiple receivers on the same frequency, they would all fire synchronously together, so you can have quite an elaborate flash setup if you wanted to. Let's now look at the remote shutter operation, which is a useful feature of this FC-16 set that allows you to have it as a flash unit or a remote shutter, so you're getting two operations from the same unit. So I removed the transmitter from the camera, removed the receiver from the flash, and we'll install the receiver onto the camera. And on the side of the receiver, we need to switch from flash mode to camera mode. And the LED will change from a green LED to a red LED to remind you you are now in a remote shutter operation. Lock that in place. Now, to connect between the remote input socket of the camera and the output socket from the receiver, you need the correct adapter cable. And with the FC-16 kit for Canon, they provide you with the C3 cable, which is for the 5D 1DX range, and the C1 cable, which fits the Rebel range and the 60D, 70D, 700D range. So I just need to connect between the socket outlet from the receiver, which is marked camera, and connect it to the input socket of the camera. So with the receiver set to the camera position, we need to now switch the transmitter to the camera position. And that will give me the opportunity to instantaneously fire the camera as I press the shutter button. Again, it mimics the shutter button on the camera. Half depress will allow the camera to focus. So if I half depress the shutter release button on the transmitter now, we'll get a constant green light. Constant green light on the receiver, and the camera is focused. And now when I depress the shutter button, the camera will fire. So once again, half depress the button, gives time for the camera to focus lock, get the beep from the camera, the two steady green lights on the transmitter and receiver. Then as I press the button down, we get a red LED and the camera fires. So again, you could have multiple cameras set up on the same frequency and fire multiple cameras simultaneously with one transmitter. So that is a really useful feature of this F16 set, that you can actually use it as a flash receiver or a wireless shutter receiver. The price on Amazon at the moment in the UK for this F16 set is £15.21, and in the States on Amazon.com it's $5.23. So it's fairly inexpensive for the role that it's carrying out for you. Well, that's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching. Hope you found that useful. And if you are a new viewer to this channel, please consider clicking that subscribe button. You'll then be notified if I do upload any new videos to this channel in your subscription list. Please do check out my photographic blog, and again I'll put a link to that in the video description below, where you'll find more write-up on the wireless triggers and also information around Panasonic cameras, and you might find those useful as well. Okay, until my next video, thanks again for watching, and it's Graham saying please take care and goodbye for now.